One thing I like to do is echo what Jesus asked for me to do. And in your lives, each and every last body in here, lives matter.
Stop the Funeral is an awesome, awesome, awesome movement. I remember years ago when Bishop wrote the book Stop the Funeral, and now to see what it's doing years and years later, it's a true testament that words never die, that we have a choice to make when it comes to our youth. Either we stop the funeral or we push the casket. The choice is ours. I'm getting higher,
feeling my and it's not about who. About we, about what we got to do going forward at all.
There has to be that avenue of the person to come in and be committed to say, even though this is what your normal has been, I have a new normal to present you with and be consistent with that. So it's offering these at-risk youth an opportunity to see life from a different perspective. Stop the Funeral was important to me because of the simple fact that we need to find collective ways as a community to stop the funeral before they even begin. And I believe to stop the funeral, we must start in the homes first, with reconditioning the parents, reconnecting the kids, and bridging that gap of understanding so they can communicate effectively, and that way we won't have so many funerals in our community.
Within a year, it was like four or five young people that got murdered. And it's like, oh my God, you know, we have to send that message out there and we have to, you know, come together. You know, it's not within the church, it's outside of the church.
The South is your movement to me means that we're coming together to stop just talking about what the issues are. And actually coming up with action plans. A lot of times we've all identified what the issues are, and we spend a lot of time talking to each other about what the issues are. But now's an opportunity where we actually need to come together to form action plans and what are our next steps, rather than just continuously talking about what's affecting all of our communities.
And so we have, you know, we're making funeral directors richer and richer off of the deceased bodies of people that could have still been here had the roof been dealt with.
So therefore, now it's like when you come, they need to see that consistency. They need to have that person that will say, you disappointed me. They need to have that person that will say, you did an excellent job.
How we can keep our young people out of the streets is by honestly having a community even just like this. That shows them love, care, that is important, that we stick by their side. Men just coming in their lives, structuring, modeling the right way, and showing them the right and the right way of how to be a man.
Again, our messaging can be broad as we want to be, but if we're not communicating, we're not reaching those cultures, or we're not putting agents in there, it ain't gonna have no impact.
So let's stop the funeral, the unjust, the uncalled funeral. And let's get back to life and excel it way beyond human imagination.